have 14 minutes to reach minimum safe distance.
Even though most of my previous analysis videos looked at art films, I would like to say that I am not against high-concept blockbuster movies. Some of my favorite movies are in the action genre, but I usually can't add much commentary to them besides saying that they were fun or entertaining to watch. And personally, I don't think many action directors and writers know how to make an effective action film anymore. It requires much more care and attention to detail than most people realize, and that is why there are so few great films in the genre.
I already dropped them!
That is why for this video, I would like to focus on one director who was able to elevate the action high-concept film up to the levels of high art. Before he started making movies, John McTiernan worked in New York theater and produced many Shakespeare revivals. After graduating from AFI, it took him several years to make his first feature film, Nomads, in 1986. It didn't do too much at the box office, but it would get him hired to direct his first of three masterpieces. What really sets McTiernan apart from other action directors is the amount of care he puts into the first acts of his films. In Predator, it is 20 minutes before one shot is fired, and in that time you get to know the rescue team and the backstory of Dutch and Dylan.
I'm going in with you, Dutch.
General, my team always works alone. You know that.
I'm afraid we all have our orders, Major. Once you reach your objective, Dylan will evaluate the situation and take charge.
The disappointing thing about modern action films is that they are afraid to have any character development or dialogue scenes because they think the audience will get bored. It is extremely important to have character scenes in action movies so the audience knows where they are and what is at stake for the heroes and villains. One explanation to why Predator is so good is that it is very similar to The Thing, even down to its opening shot. Both have a powerful alien that you can't see trying to destroy a team of humans, and it comes down to one hero to finally kill it at the end. I don't know if the Thomas brothers were inspired by The Thing when they wrote Predator, but it would explain why they are so alike. Predator proved to studios that McTiernan could make a successful action film, so 20th Century Fox decided to give him control of a film that they had been unable to make for nearly 10 years. Based on the novel Nothing Lasts Forever, Die Hard would become one of the most influential movies of all time. It spawned four sequels and countless imitators, but none of them came close to the magic of the original. I think the reason why lightning never struck twice is that you could never find a more perfect location or character for an action movie. The character of John McClane was one of the first relatable heroes in a decade of Superman. He had a working class job, troubles at home, and phobias.
This company, they figure a married woman's got
You are a married woman, Holly. You're married to me.
We're going to have this conversation again. We did this in July.
We never finished this conversation in July.
I had an opportunity. I had to take
it. Right, no matter what the consequences.
He was also one of the first action characters who decided that to run and hide was the smarter idea than to reveal himself to the enemy. Shooting without a finished script, McTiernan tried to find moments for McClane to show his humanity to the audience.
That she is the best thing that ever happened to a bum like me. She's heard me saying I love you 1,000 times. She never heard me say I'm sorry. And I want you to tell her that, Al. I want you to tell her that John said that he was sorry. Okay? You got that, man?
Yeah, I got it, John.
It isn't very often that the lead of your action film is willing to admit their flaws before going into the final battle. To make a great action film, you need to build up your action sequences slowly, so you have the biggest stunt for last. The location of the Nakatomi Plaza was perfect because it confined you to one place for a whole film, and you could easily know how to make each action scene top the last. So by the end of the film, they literally blow off the roof. I think that explains why the other diehards never worked as well. Die Hard 2 used an airport, and the rest used major cities. Those settings were just too big for beat cop John McClane to realistically handle all alone. The blockbuster success of Die Hard would make Bruce Willis a star, and one would think the film's director. Unfortunately for McTiernan, he would have only one more classic film in his future. Based on the Tom Clancy novel, The Hunt for Red October posed a question that had not been asked in any submarine movie. What if a captain of a nuclear sub wanted to make peace instead of war? The film's main character, Captain Ramius, embodies the Cold War exhaustion that both the US and USSR had in the late 80s.
40 years. A war at sea. A war with no battles. No monuments. Only casualties. I widowed her the day I married her.
The film is actually one of the most optimistic action movies ever made. It displays the best of humanity and shows that trust and friendship can be developed even by sworn enemies.
Welcome to the new world, sir.
Within 2 years of the film's release, the Soviet Union dissolved, and the Cold War would end. McTiernan would continue to make films, including another Die Hard, but his hot streak was officially over when The Last Action Hero flopped at the box office. And because of a 2006 false statement charge, he has been unable to make a film in the last decade, and is now in a South Dakota prison until April 2014. It is unlikely that McTiernan will get another chance now at making another blockbuster, but his previous work will always stand as a benchmark to the action genre, and be a testament to his talents as a filmmaker. Thanks for watching.